Hello YouTube, today at powerjackrepair.org we got an Asus laptop GL752V, GL752VW-IH74. The client states that the jack is broken, so we will try to remove this thing. So we're gonna take this laptop apart. It's called the ROG Sonic Bass. Let's see. Oh, there is something. Republic of Games. Okay. ROG. Let's write down. It's a ROG. A Republic of Games. Okay. Public of Games. All right. Republic of Games. Let's see if we can get it done in the right manner. So. One. Two. There is no screws in there. Help of those. Alrighty, remove this cover right here, set the cover aside. Here we got the, there's a whole bunch of garbage flying inside. One screw. Okay, so that's going in right there. On this channel, we got about 1000 plus videos of laptop power jack repairs. Power connectors, power socket, power input, ports, DC inlets, repairs. And if you're not gonna see something on this particular video, you could just check out 1000 other videos, I'm sure. I'm sure you're gonna be able to find what you're looking for in there. Now, we improve the quality of our videos all the time. So I'm sure we have one of those videos with this laptop before, from way before. It's just the quality of those videos wasn't really up to par to quality of this video. This is also not the best quality because of this white spot right here, but I can't really do anything about it as of yet because everything costs money and the channel lives off of the donations. So people donate, I spend money on equipment. So. Alright, so another screw came off right here. Now the goal is to see if I could just use the guitar pick to separate the two casings. Alright, let's see. Alright, there are a bunch of cables on the inside. So what you wanna do? Don't pull on this thing all the way up. You kind of have to separate it. And then you have to flip it over. Like that. Then you have to switch the camera to record what we got here. And like that. So we got three cables disconnected here, and that's all the cables there are. Alrighty, so that's the jack right here, which I haven't. Oh, and You see what's wrong with this hinge right here. So that's probably the reason why everything is kind of messed up. So yeah, I'm not sure if I got a jack like that. I will have to go and look, but let's see if we can just remove this whole thingy from, I wonder where is the cable going under the, oh, the cable goes on this side. Okay, so we can lift up this guy, move the cable out of the way, like that. And right, so we got the entire assembly outwards, and that's how it was positioned. Now, yeah, that's a heavy duty jack. Let me go look for it. Alrighty, so we do have a jack like that here. Hold on. Well, I got the replacement jack, but the problem is, even if I put it in, it has nothing to hold on to, because this is just gonna fall inside. And I think this jack, well, yeah, I mean, all of that just gonna fall inwards. Anyways, let me go and look for something different. This time I'm gonna bring the laptop along. All right, so I made an executive decision. I'm gonna be installing this jack instead of a jack like that, for a simple reason. This will have a lot more points to grab onto the hot glue that's gonna be right there. I'm gonna just hot glue everything in here, and this thing will definitely be sitting there much better, maybe even like that upside down. I will see in a second, but this is what I'm gonna put in. I just want to make sure that either way I put in is gonna be just fine. It looks like that. Okay, so let's put the glasses on and start working on this jack right here. And the first thing I want to do is cut this side leg. All right, cut it off. And now we're going to do the other side. Okay. Like that. And I'm just making sure it's all gonna be fitting inside. Let's see. And this top cover is broken also. Here. Let's see if it fits. Yeah, it fits ideally. Just like perfect. So I'm gonna shove it like that. And yeah, that's the way how it's gonna be installed. And once I solder all of the connections, nothing gonna be in the way here. Let's see, like that, right? Yeah, so I'm gonna put some hot glue on the bottom here, then I'm gonna press this guy downwards like that and make sure it's stable, and then I'm gonna hot glue the jack in place as well. And it's gonna be a forever type of repair, so nothing to worry about. Now the thing is, I need to desolder the wires from this jack, solder it to this jack, make sure that it's all gonna be connecting just fine. Yeah, and it will have nowhere to go. Yeah, here. Yeah, you see how it's gonna be moving now? So yeah, once I'm done, it should be nice and stable. Let's add some flux to the connection so that the wire is gonna come off easy.
Easy breezy, beautiful. Come on. Come on. Okay, like that. Now let's try and get this thing out. Come on, let's go. Let's go like that. Beautiful. All right. Now let's plug in the new. All right, so what I'm gonna do now is added some flux to the rear of the jack. And here we're gonna add some solder to the wiring. And then once we add some solder to the rear, we just gonna rub the cables like that. Looks good. Okay, looks good. Looks good, and now we're gonna shove this wire right here in between those two negative components, like that. And we're just gonna solder it up quite nicely, like that. Like that. Good job. Good job. Let's solder it up on this side as well. Like that. Again, the reason we need those fins in the back, don't cut off the fins in the back, because once we hot glue everything together, that's what's gonna hold the glue from. That's what's gonna hold the jack from getting pushed in all the time. All right. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add some hot glue right there on the bottom and some hot glue under the jack and in the back of the jack, and basically pancake everything together here. All right, let's go. All right, let's pray for everything going the way it's supposed to go. Let's see. You know what, I do want to put some glasses on, because this whole thing isn't exactly ideal for. All right, so we're gonna just put it down like that. Now let's put it down like that. Good job. I do want to fixate it in place, so I'm adding a little bit more here. One. Alrighty, so what I'm gonna do now, I'm just gonna sit like that for about 5 minutes, maybe 10 minutes, and hold everything, keep the pressure down. So I'm gonna pause the video. I decided to add a little bit more hot glue, just in case. Yeah, looks good. Want to make sure to trim a little bit right here, because there is a metal bracket that goes on top of this area, and that's pretty much all I need to trim. The rest of it, hopefully everything is already much harder than supposed to be. Still I need to take 10 more minutes or so to harden things up. Alright, so here is a different angle on what I done. Basically hot glue the jack on the bottom, hot glue on the top, hot glue all around, cleaned out this area so that the top would be holding it down, and it's gonna be holding down everything forever, I hope. I think most of the I hopes went bankrupt in 2020 because they had a really slim margin. Let's see if we can just connect all of the wires here. Can you see what I'm doing here? Yeah. All right. So let's connect. Like that. Close it down. Let's bring this more like that. Okay. And the last wire, make sure not to break it. This one is usually the most brittle wire there is. All right. Well, assuming the broken parts that were there flying all over the casing are not, haven't shorted anything on the motherboard, the whole thing should work. No, it's all good. Looks good to me. Let's see if I could press it on the bottom here. Yeah. Okay. Feels like something is still flying around there on the inside. Let's separate the casing one more time. And let's bend it over all together. I just wanted to get all of the garbage outwards. All right. I was thinking I took all the garbage already out of the laptop, but not really. No, I mean, I had to open it up one more time. Okay, good job. Good job. Now let's flip it over. Let's connect the hard drive to the laptop. All right, and now let's screw in the three screws right here. And the two most important screws are one right here. Right there. So once those screws are in, you can pretty much put down this screw right here, that screw right there, this screw right here,
and right there like that. Like that, and another silver screw going in here. Now we're gonna put in the CD drive in, and we got a whole bunch of screws here. 1, 2. Three, four, five, six. All right. And one screw is missing in action. Someplace. Okay. All right. So we're gonna. Oh, yeah. There was one screw missing for sure. All right. So let's do. Alrighty, so this laptop requires 120 watts, so 6.32 amps. This power supply that the client provided is only 90 watts. Let me show you here. That's 4.7 amps. 4.7 multiplied by 19, that's just 90 watts. Should probably say 90 watts someplace, right? Anyways, here, let's plug it in. All right, so we plugged it in. All right, so I found a compatible power supply, 120 watts right there. Yeah, it looks like that, but oh well. And here we got the laptop charging just fine. You see, right there, plugged in, charging. And the networks are picking up. Let me switch to the... All right, anyways, touchpad works, the keyboard works. We're all set. Thank you so much for watching. And you guys have a good day. Please leave a like. Thank you so much for leaving a like in advance. If you stop by, this laptop should take about an hour and 20 minutes to fix. So, all right. Okay, guys, have a good day. Thanks. Bye.